of you. Today we are discussing about the laboratory practicals or laboratory experiments. Under the electrical material and wiring practice, we are performing the video lectures on EMW subject. Our subject code is 22328. Total 32 practicals are allotted for this subject. Under the teaching and examination case scheme, for the practical assessment, that means each experiment have for the 50 marks and end semester exam which are conducted internally. For that examination, 50 marks are allotted. So the total 100 marks allotted from the practical activities. List of experiment. Total 32 practicals are allotted for this subject, in which these are the list of indicates which are the practicals which we are performed in the laboratories. Okay, now we are start our experiment number one, which is subtopic is use different electrical safety accessories and practice. Myself, Mr. Vaswadi Yogesh, lecturer from Electrical Department, SIT Polytechnic, Yatra. For practical number one, safety practice is more important. Therefore, for this practical significance is it is essential to observe safety while working with electrical installation, appliances, panel, etc. The knowledge of safety accessories and procedure to be followed while performing the electrical work is essential for human life as well as the quality and life of machine, equipment, wires and cables. In practical significance, we can observe the safety is a major issue for day by day laborers and skilled laborers. Each year, accident happens frequently in any working place. So, it is an electrical shock happens when an electrical current passes through our body. This can be burn, both internal and external issues, and cause organ damage. Mainly, factors affecting on electrical shock is voltage, length of time, electricity path through our body, and the type of current. Therefore, it is essential to we follow the safe practices under the working condition or any electrical place where which are work. Due to this safety practice, human life as well as equipment, machine life will be increases, and also huge amount of cost will be reduces for the increasing the human life as well as machine life. It is required to follow the safe practices. Relevant program outcomes. For this experiment, we are required three program outcomes, or our program outcomes for this practicals is first is discipline knowledge. Apply electrical engineering knowledge to solve broad-based electrical engineering related problems. That means we solve the electrical safety problems by following the safety rules or wearing the safety accessories. Experiment and practice. Plan to perform experiment and practices to use the result to solve a broad-based electrical engineering problem. Due to wearing the electrical safety accessories and following the safety rules, we can solve a electrical engineering problem by performing the safety rules or following the safety activities. Third point is engineering tools. Apply relevant electrical technology and tools with an understanding of the limitations. Any electrical accessories have the some type of limitations, so that we can improve these limitations by using the advanced technologies, and we can reduces the limitations under the various electrical activities. Competition practical skills. This practical is expected to develop the following skill for the industry identified competency. That means planning, plant, wiring or cabling activities using relevant material following safe practices, in which we can develop the safety practices skill while working in wiring or cabling activities relevant to the electrical engineering materials, in which use various types of electrical safety accessories. And second is follow the electrical safety practice. By practical skill and competency increases by using the this following electrical safety rules and electrical safety practice while working under the cabling or wiring activities and other electrical activities under the safe condition. This is the images which is show the when we cannot follow the electrical practices, then electrical accident will be happened, so that it is damages the equipment, also damages the human life, or sometime death will be occurred. Next is relevant course outcome. Follow the safe practice when undertaking electrical work. CO assigned for this practical is follow safe practice when undertaking electrical work. Practical outcome is use different electrical safety accessories and practice. That means we can use or how to use the electrical safety accessories, what is advantage of wearing the electrical accessories, and what is the types of various types of electrical safety accessories, etc. Relevant effective domain related outcomes. Practice good housekeeping with safety measures. Demonstrate working as a leader or a team member. Maintain tool and equipment. Follow the ethical practice. Minimum theoretical breakdown is safety procedure and practice are essential in electrical work. Basic approaches to electrical work from the point of view ensuring safety, which include inbuilt safety in procedure such as permit to work system, safety instruction and safety practices, are covered in SP 30 2011. In National Electrical Code 2011 section 9, which is related to the safety in electrical work. The minimum theoretical background about the electrical safety is following the safety procedure as well as safety practice under the electrical work or while working in electrical place. This separate safety practice is mentioned in SP 30 2011 electrical code, which are National Electrical Code, which indicates the how we can perform the electrical activities under the safe working condition, so that this code is available in our laboratory. Also, IE rules for the safety we can complete in our first chapter, second lecture, which are related to the IE rule, that means Indian Electrical Rules for the Safety. Practical setup or circuit diagram or work situation. These are the safety accessories which are we are used in the place of electrical work or under the performing electrical work. This is hand gloves, safety shoes, safety helmet, etc. Resources required. The suggested resources by the MSBT is for the subject is National Electrical Code 2011, which are available in our laboratory. Second is recommendation on safety procedure and practice in electrical work, part 1, IS 5216, part 1, which are we are covered in unit number 1, that means it is IE rules regarding to the electrical safety. Third suggest is material is rubber insulated electrical gloves, which are specification is working potential 7.5 kV or 7500 volt. One pair electrical shockproof safety shoes, which rating is insulation range between 50 to 30 kV. One pair safety apron standard rating one number, safety helmet standard one number, and safety belt which are standard. It is also quantity required is one number. Next is precaution to be followed. While working in electrical installation, we can perform some precautions or follow some precautions, in which number one is switch off the main. That means we can switch off the main supply or main switch from which supply is fed to the circuit for the electrical circuit to be overhauled or worked on. That means while working in electrical installation, we can switch off the electrical supply or electrical main switch. Always hang on the tag on main switch. The tag should be read work in progress. Also, we can hang on the tag on main switch which are indicated the work in progress. Use rubber gloves, rubber boots, apron, safety helmet and safety belt etc. before starting our electrical work. That means before starting our electrical work, we can wear the safety accessories. Third point is all electrical leads should be considered as a live until it is positively proved that they are not. Check the circuit with test lamp. Before we starting our work, we can assume that or considered our electrical leads, that means open conductors, are live. That means the supply is present at that wire or at that cable, so that we can check first by using test lamp the supply is present or not. After that, we can work at that place. Fourth point is if ladder is used, it must be held by the another person so that it may be not slip away while we using the ladder for climbing. Then it is held by the another person so that it is not slipped away. Next point is before replacing a blown fuse, always remember to put the switch in off condition or off position. When we replace the blown fuse, then it is required to be this main switch or main ICDP or ICTP switch will be in off condition. You cannot replace the fuse by using or in on position of the switch. These are the some precaution which are we followed under the electrical condition or while working in electrical place procedure, in which first is identify various electrical accessories. That means identify various electrical safety accessories, note down the specification in the table resources used. Which safety accessories we are used in the laboratory or while working in laboratory or electrical place, then we note down the resources used in our specification table. Use rubber insulated electrical gloves. Wear insulated rubber hand gloves in both hands. Switch off the any main switch in the laboratory. Remove the KitKat fuses from the main switch. Check the fuse wire. Replace it with same rating if necessary. Place the KitKat fuses in the main switch. Switch on the main switch. Note down, students shall use other electrical safety accessories like rubber boots, apron, safety helmets, safety belts in vigilance of teacher. Here our one activity is given, in which we wear the rubber insulated electrical gloves and we can replace the fuse, in which first process is we can wear the electrical gloves, switch off the main switch of the supply, remove the KitKat fuses from the main switch, check the fuse wire is or not. If it is blown, then replaced it, placed in KitKat fuses in the main switch. That means we can place this fuse in main switch, switch on the main supply, etc. Third point is follow electrical practice. Read the SP30-2011 National Electrical Code 2019 Section 19 Safety in Electrical Work and IS 52-16 Part 1. These both are IS as are present in laboratory. We can read at the time of practical session. Okay, prepare a report on permit to work, safety instruction, safety practice. We can prepare the report according to the IE rule or IS 52-16 Part 1, which are related to the electrical work or electrical safety work. Okay, these are the process we can follow under the safety practice, or while working in electrical installation, we wear the safety accessory. Now we study about the electrical safety accessories and its use or application of electrical accessories. IS 52-16 Part 1 we can study in, or we are studying in unit number 1, IE rule for the safety. In IE rule for the safety, we start from IE rule number 3 to IE rule number 61, which are give the information about to permit to work, safety instruction and safety practices. According to these IE rules, we can prepare the report. Now we can study the various types of electrical safety accessories, in which we can study about the first helmet or hard hat, second is safety glasses or safety goggles, third point is protective clothing, okay, next point is electrician gloves or safety hand gloves, next is safety shoes or protective boots, next is insulated rubber mat or dielectric mat, and last is safety belts. These all are the electrical safety accessories which are used in electrical installation or under the working of electrical field. Safety accessories is also known as personal protective equipments, specifically designed to help to protect the worker against health or safety risk on the job site. By wearing the health or safety risk on the job site, the appropriate safety accessories workers can decrease the number of preventable accidents that occurs on job site every year. Safety accessories is designed to protect worker from serious workplace injuries or illness resulting from contact with radiological, physical, electrical, mechanical or other workplace. Safety accessories provide the protection to the head, goggle. Goggles are provide the protection to the hand gloves provide the protection to the hand, boots provide the protection to the foot, and safety belt provide the falling from the heighted object. First is safety helmet or hard hat. Severe electrical helmets are designed for protection against accidental falls and protection from falling object and additional protection from overhead live wires while working on live lines. There are mainly two parts of safety helmet: shell and suspension. These are outer body is the shell and inner is the suspension. These helmets are adjustable. These suspensions are adjustable. This backside knob is available for the adjustment of helmet as per our head requirement. Chin strap. There are three types of helmets: Class G, Class E, or Class C helmets, which are used general usage, electrical, and conducting headwear. Helmets are protect from the helmet provide the protection from two points. First is head impact or top impact. Second is side impact, top impact and side impact. Helmets protect from two impacts. Next is eye and face protection. Goggles or safety glasses are forms of protective eyewear that usually enclose or protect the area of the eye in order to prevent particulates, waters, or chemicals from strike the eyes. They are used in chemistry laboratories and woodworking. Goggles are often power tools, drills, chainsaw to prevent flying particles from damaging the eyes. It protects from dust, dirt, vapor, powder, mist, etc. Statistics shows that 3 out of 5 workers suffering eye injuries were no protection. Half of those who died wore the wrong type of incorrectly or wore the wrong type of glasses. It protects eye at the time of welding work, furnace work, and short circuit conditions. Therefore, eye protection is more important. The safety goggles are special types of goggles, which are not a normal goggles, because the glass thickness is more than normal goggles, which are provide the protection against any type of dust, dirt, vapor, powder, moisture, chemicals. The size of the glasses are given side of the goggles. When we wear the goggles, then it is required to adjust the goggle according to our eye requirement. There are many types of goggles available in the market. Next is face shield. Face shield provide from the various types of dust, dirt, sparking of electrical sparking, or any type of grinding sparking. Face shield provide from the or provide the protection to the head, eyes, or mouth. It will be adjust on the our helmet. Three important rules about eyewear. Be sure it fits according to the our eye requirement or face requirement. The eyewear or goggles should be adjustable. If it is not adjustable, then replace it. It is the adjustable system of the goggle. It should be properly clean. Defective or deficient safety glasses must be always be replaced, and it should be keep in protective conditions and always wear it. Eye is more important part of our body. Next is hearing protection. There are mainly two types of hearing protection. First is single protection and second is double protection. Above the 85 decibel volume level, we required a single protective or single protection of our ear. There are many types of earplugs available: pre-molded earplugs, formable earplugs, disposable earplugs, customized earplugs, molded earplugs, etc. It is also adjusted in our helmet. Above 105 degrees Celsius or 105 decibel level of volume, we can provide the protection to our ear. Once again, I repeat that above 105 decibel level or volume level of 105 decibel, we can provide the double protection to our ear. Proper fittings are required for the earplugs and also dual protection of the ear. There are second protection which were provided by the worker to the eye. This is first protection and this is the second protection. First is ear plug and it is outer plug. Before wearing it, check it properly. Next is gloves and hand protection. Gloves provide the protection to our hand. The safety rubber hand gloves are always used for online work to insulate the human body or operator from the electrical supply. The danger of electrical shock from leakage current is also avoided from the rubber hand gloves. The hand gloves manufactured for various operating voltages for LT line up to 600 volt, it is differently manufactured, and for 11 kV and 33 kV, etc., it is differently designed and manufactured. To be effective, electrical safety gloves must be incorporate high dielectric and physical strength, along with flexibility and durability. These types of mainly safety hand gloves used in our electrical requirement or electrical field. Next is protective footwear. Normally, safety shoes protect our feet from falling object or compression, chemical reaction, extreme heat or cold, slipping, spill and splashes, fire, etc. But the electrical safety shoes provide electrical protection to their insulating property level to stop electrical current from being grounded. The material is used for shoes is full leather and fitted with non-metallic fiber toe. The electrical shock resistance up to the 11 kV for 1 minute and sole is made from the polyurethane material. While wearing the shoes, it is comfortable with your fate. Before is wearing it, check it properly where it is, or it is in good condition or not. It is the application of safety shoes. Next is full body protection or limb protection. Work in areas that are susceptible to fire, explosion, or arc flash. Must wear fire retardant, fire resistance, and/or flash-rated clothing, which are protect the labor worker or electrical engineer from the fire hazards. Dust particle, dirt particle, etc. Or electrical sparking, grinding sparking, etc. Or it is also employee responsibility to use the wear proper body and limb protection. Further, if you are working with chainsaw or cutting devices out in the open, you will require cut resistance, leggings, and torso protection. Next is electrical safety rubber mat. The rubber mats are always used in the front of all control panels and if it required a switchboards. The main purpose of rubber mat is at the time of earth fault or earth leakage current operators, human body is isolated from the ground or earth by danger of electrical shock is avoided. It is the applications of electrical safety mats. In front of control panels, in front of meter boards, it is made from the specially polyurethane material. As per BIS and ISS marker, IS number 15652 in 2016, it is approved by the CPRI or IRDA. Next is safety belt. Safety belt provide the protection from the VR while working in any heighted object or any heighted place, then safety belt provide the protection from falling to our body. It is the method of how to wear the safety belt. It is the hook attached to the belt and this hook is connected to the any fixed object. This is hook is fixed to the any fixed object. Use of सबके हैंड ग्लोव्स विच आर वी यूज इन द वाइल वर्किंग इन इलेक्ट्रिकल फील्ड. इन ओवरहेड लाइन्स, इन इंडोर एप्लीकेशन वेयर आवर बॉडी इज डायरेक्टली इन कॉन्टेक्ट विद द ओपन वायर्स और एनी हाई वोल्टेज एरियाज. It is the use of safety belt. If we wear the safety belt properly, then we are hang on the fixed object. Otherwise, we are falling on heighted object. Now, our this practical session is completed. In this table, you are written the resources used in this practicals. What are actual procedure we are followed? This actual procedure we can write, or you can write as per your understanding. Observation and calculations are not available for this practicals. Next is result. Next, interpretation of result and conclusion. You are written in your own language by understanding level of your knowledge. Next is practical related question. You can find out these questions on internet or any book. Okay. Our lecture is completed. Thank you. Next time we can see the practical number 2, in which we studied about the various types of safety tools and its applications, etc. Okay, thank you.